Good morning, everyone. Dr. Victoria Scorpio here, speaking to you from the Seeds of Transformation Healing Center in Wareham, Massachusetts. Today is Sunday, August 15th, and the moon for most of the day is in Scorpio. A special shout out to my friend Kerry, who I have known since the mid-80s. I first met her, I think she was 15. And I won't tell you how old she is today, but needless to say, we've known each other a long, long time. Have a great birthday, Kerry, and I feel some really great things coming for you this year. So, and coming for you in a good way, not in, they're coming for you. All right. So today we have the first quarter moon with the moon in Scorpio and the sun in Leo. It is a crisis in action square, so we are going to feel the need to take an action, to build structures that can support our life, a life based on, not based on the past, but building for the future, but driven by a need to escape the ghosts of the past and escape the way the past has been run. Maybe in the past it worked. Oftentimes it didn't even work in the past, but that's another story. And now it's time for new ideas and new structures. We have a the moon in Scorpio is very desirous. Scorpio deals with our desire nature, that which we feel we don't have, actually, and which we desire to have in our life, as opposed to Taurus, the opposite sign of Scorpio, which is really about what we have. So the combination of Scorpio moon and Leo sun is a very passionate one. It really is about taking life by the horns, or I was going to use a different part of the anatomy of the bull, but you know what I'm saying. I mean, it's really going for it. So we're going to, that energy is here today, that energy of wanting to go for it. Now we do have the moon does make a supportive connection to Pluto. But it does square Jupiter. So we may have the strength today and the fortitude and the opportunity, but we do need to make sure that we don't overextend ourselves and think we can do more than we can actually do. We also have a sesquiquadrate between Venus and Uranus. And sesquiquadrates are crisis in... Our crisis producing, actually. And of course, Uranus and Venus deals with our relationship. Well, Venus deals with our relationships. And Uranus deals with something surprising, something different, something perhaps challenging. Now, let me just see. I have to do this in my head. If Venus is in Virgo. So this is a humbling aspect. It is an aspect, it's kind of an ego-busting aspect. So if somebody is all super sure of themselves when it comes to relationships, they can have a shock. It's almost like you don't see it coming. So just be aware of that. Oh, hi, Bun. I just almost walked into the bunny. Hi, bunny, how you doing? Sorry, I didn't mean to scare you. So that's going on. And then we also have, later tonight, we have Mercury squaring the nodes of the moon. Mercury, of course, in Virgo, squaring the north and south node. And we can feel like we're caught between the future and the past, but the way ahead, the best direction for our minds and what we focus on, from a mental level is practical solutions and communication moving us into the future. It's not about the past. It's about moving into the future. We can learn from the past. We can utilize those lessons, but we certainly don't want to dwell. And of course, the past being the South Node in Sagittarius has to do with the things that we believe, sometimes whether we have proof or not, and old ways of believing that have perhaps served us at some point in our life, but now it's about sort of letting go of that. However, it's less about letting go, really, and more about just moving forward, and that's kind of the energy for the day. And then lastly, the moon makes a supportive sextile to Venus. I think it's tomorrow. Venus is going to be changing signs, moving into Libra, where she is much, much more comfortable than she is in Virgo. And so a lot of that critical relationship theory, I guess we could call it, is going to decrease a willingness to relate to one another and work with one another. Oh, there's a little hummingbird. Let me see if it's all around the flowers down there. They're so little, I don't know if you can see them. Oh, maybe I should focus better on them. Yeah. He'll probably come over by the feeder too. Oh, there he goes, right to the feeder. See that? Yeah. Oh, that was two hummingbirds running after each other. They almost crashed into me. You probably heard them. I don't know if you saw them. Oh, there he is. Hi. There's a lot of flowers out here now that the hummingbirds like to eat. Or like to, I guess, they don't eat the flowers. Yeah, I get the nectar from. One of them, actually, is this cleodendron over here. And they love this. Butterflies love this too. Oh, back there's the hummingbird at the cleodendron. And then this big pile here in front of us, that's jewelweed. Jewelweed is an antidote for, what's that stuff? Poison ivy. Did you know that? anyway, they love the jewelweed as well. And the other yellow stuff that's blooming now is the goldenrod, which is always beautiful. Always beautiful. It's all the way back there. These bird sounds are mostly the stuff that's a little discordant. It's mostly hummingbirds. they're very beautiful. They remind us to stay in the moment, but they're very territorial. So they know the boundaries and they will fight for their boundaries. Hummingbirds always remind me of my sister Patty, who passed going on 3 years this coming Saturday. One of the reasons why I'm going down to visit my family down in Delaware is to celebrate my sister's beautiful, beautiful life and her beautiful spirit. But hummingbirds are the thing that remind me of her the most, because they're fast, they're beautiful, they're ephemeral, and they're ballsy. What is that? Mighty, tiny but mighty. All right, guys, I'm going to let you guys go. I guess we'll just end up on this beautiful arrangement here. Oh, and this one over here is beautiful, too. And my shadow, me and my shadow. La, 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 la. There's some begonias there. Some, what's that called? Some begonias, these big green ones, those are angel wing begonias, and coleus, I love coleus. It really, It doesn't, it does well. This is like partial sun over here on the side. It does well in that partial sun, and the color is just so beautiful. I just love it. And then over here, we have some, the purple is heliotrope. Hi there. A little, oh, here he comes. You want to show everybody? Hi, Chipper. Hi, Chipster. Hi. Anyway, coleus, not coleus, heliotrope is purple, and then these, red, the things in the front here, there's the geraniums. Yeah, and this actually, oh, and that is a, maybe a verbena, I forget what that's called, the one right there. I think that might be a verbena, but, yeah. Beautiful. It's a beautiful morning today, guys. This is the first morning where I haven't felt like I've walked out into my own bathtub, my warm, hot, wet bathtub. So I'm grateful for the little bit of cool and the lack of humidity of the morning here. I'm going to stay out here as long as I can get away with it before it gets too hot. And the sun's coming up, so it's starting to warm up. All right, guys, I will let you go. I promise I'd let you go. I'm going to let you go now. Much love, everyone. Have a great week. It's going to check out my week ahead. A lot of information in that one. It's almost an hour long. Sorry, guys. But there's a lot of stuff happening this week that you need to know about. So check that out if you haven't already. And I love all of you. And have a great Sunday.